texture 26, and I'll just drag it onto the model, and you'll see this texture shows up. We have some UV problems as far as the texture stretching on different surfaces. So let's just assign one large UVW map to this by going to our modifier list and adding a UVW map. And it's usually set to default as plane, so we're going to want to put that into a box so we get a nice even surface over all the faces. And you can go ahead and click the added UVW map to make sure that it's selected and change your transform. And we'll go ahead and just wallpaper that we've chosen for the bottom floor. So you might run into this a few times. I run into it still to this day, whereas I think this is a good idea at one part of texturing the model, and then I get down to another area where I think, okay, this is even better. And it becomes a pain to go back and select all the faces of the material that I want to replace, and then replace it with the material that I would like. And one quick way of actually reducing the amount of time in doing that is just go ahead and, with the polygon element selected, we'll go ahead and select a polygon of the material we want. And you'll see it highlights ID of 8. So if we say select all faces that have an ID of 8, it selects all the wood faces for us. We can go ahead and just replace that by hitting M for our material editor, and we'll just drag this new concrete texture onto it. Okay, and we can do the same for our two different wallpapers. So if we select one of the faces that has the wallpaper, we say, hey, it has an ID of 9. We'll select all the faces that have that same ID, and again, hit M to pull up the material editor, and we'll just drag our wallpaper 4 on it. Okay, and then we'll come in and do the same thing for this one. Select all faces that have an ID material of 7, and we will replace that with wallpaper 4. Great. So, because we went through level by level, this is the problem that you also run into when you want to replace one material with another one, is that the UVs are off. The top level has one resolution of UV, the middle has a different, and the bottom has another different one. So using that same trick, let's just select all faces that have an ID of 10, and we'll add a new UVW map. Okay. And we'll change our transform to a scale, and we'll just scale this down to a ratio, or an even ratio, from top, front, and left. Okay. And then we'll go ahead and just scale them all to bring in a tighter resolution. Maybe something like that. And collapse this yet again. And that's our new consistent look across all the floors. Our first floor